Thank you. Thank you. Special welcome to all of you, our special guests. Special greetings to family, our very honorable chief who came to see his colleague celebrated. Allow me to tell a little story, and I'm going to be very chronological. Queen Dr. Jane, here seated, is known in the family as Mummy Science before she became a doctor. In every single topic that is put in the family forum, Jane goes into science and pulls something and brings an argument. Specialist. So she is one of those, just like our president rightly said, who will not be an ordinary doctor. She will be a game changer because her world is about looking for solutions. Let's please put a hand for her. Now let's go to the queen, to the king. When the king was finishing his primary school, the mother went to school. He was forced to relocate to the village. When children are going to school, he leaves home, going to school, and ends in the bush. When the kids are coming back, he gets a number of them well beaten. So he was feared by many when he was growing up. Again, remember that the mother went to school, so he suffered some years because of that transition. So he wrote his ordinary letters with the younger sister, Princess Delphine, who's right here with us. When results came out, I remember very well, a comment of Gideon Taka said, "Delphine has passed. I know the king has failed." Because when he listened, he had one Taka. When we went through the list, the king passed. As I said, I'm going to be chronological. I came back from university and I was teaching in Longla. And I was squatting in his house because I taught from four to opposite. One of my students is Princess Eunice, right here. And when I, because I had no beard, and I was very young. In fact, most of the students in the upper seat, you know, long life for that matter, had white beards, okay? So I was very threatened as a young teacher, and I had to sleep the whole night reading to God made these celebrated repetees. But what I noticed was that when the king came back from school, I think CCC then, he would go drinking mbu with his friends, drinking metal quarters or something. And when he comes back into the room, he would seal the place like a coffin so that his friends do not know he's reading. So while most of his friends drank and slept, by the time he wrote advanced level, everybody knew he would pass. He had beaten everybody at all levels. Now, after the advanced level, it was, what is the next step? In a family like ours, if you want to go to school to whatever level, somebody will sponsor you. It doesn't need to be your biological mother or father. It's a tradition that has been there for decades. So, Mbe, His Royal Highness finishes, passes his advanced level, first time in flying colors. And I was already in South Africa then. So I call him and I say, "So which university are you going?" He said, "I'm going to the military." I did not argue because he was called a general from those days from the primary school. So that was his passion. We knew he would be a general someday. But as you know, that funny ex-country of ours, Southern Cameroon, ex-country of ours, the king tried the military exam using all those techniques you know in that funny ex-country and flunked. Even though he was running from Pinyin to Bamenda, that was his practice every morning. So when he flunked, it gave me a great opportunity. I called him and I said, "You've been home for 10 months. Now let me give you a little tactic. You know you," and he, "we used to buy Okrika. This man used to deceive mom and dad. He only wore originals. He's always been like that." So I thought that was a soft angle. So I said, Tell mom and dad you want to go to the University of Yaoundé. So that you are sure they'll give you your school fees, they'll give you pocket money, and while you are in Yaoundé, you can be chopping your life, don't even go into school. I was deceiving him because I knew he had a brain. I knew that once his school fees is paid and he gets into class day one, he's going to get a degree. You know what he told me? I want to go to the military. It became evident that the king could not make it into the military because of the system, and then he showed the appetite to come to South Africa. And then he found himself in South Africa. Within 6 months, the man was driving a car bigger than mine. I don't know how he did it. I don't know how he did it. But the long and short is that we are celebrating a man who's highly favored and blessed, who seems to be the apple of God's eye because everything he touches explodes. It's been like that. I used to joke that if he sells, a Nigerian sell water, if he decides to sell a pillow, you don't know what a pillow is, he will still make money. He will still make money. But on the journey of him having a first degree, we were privileged to have mom join us. We celebrated that in Durban, and we put on a wrap on mom, and most of them use it as their, what do you call that thing? Profile picture. We are here to celebrate God, and I think we should equally just bring mom into the room and celebrate her as well. Mom has 9 children. I'm going to call some of them here. Veji, please stand up. Princess Veji, stand up. Princess Delphine, stand up. Princess Manu Karin, stand up. Princess Kirsten, stand up. Those are 4, right? At me? That's 5. At there? There are 2 hiding inside here. I would not show. You could just look. And then there's a chartered accountant in the UK that most of you know. But if there's anything really big today I want us to know and thank God for, is that of all of these children, including Bear standing up, 4 of them had a master's degree this year.
Properly, because as at now, the occasion hasn't begun. Everybody's looking the same. I mean, we are all just dressed. But we need to see the people who have the occasion, the people we came here to honor. So we have a bit of an issue with space here, and I will please, if it is possible, if it is not possible, it's fine, but if it is possible for you to shift your seat in, please, let me inconvenience you for a little bit. As soon as they come in, you are going to get back to your comfort zone, to your comfortable position. Thank you. The Queen, do you need like a maid of honor kind of, you know, because this wedding, please do maid of honor, thank you. Okay, please, you can sit down for now. When they come in, then we are all going to stand and dance with them. I believe we are here because we love them, we are happy with what they have achieved, so this is about to be the climax of the occasion. Thank you. Interlude of music. Sharp, sharp. Okay, DJ.
I see something red. Please respect the column, respect that rock, respect it.
Red.
Please clap with them, clap.
And you
dance together,
down.
Please. As we dance, we clap, 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 clap.
Prostitute! 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 Yeah.
We are literally walking on money.
We are literally walking on money.
You see, yes, let me walk. Let me walk on money. Let me walk on money.
We are doing this thing.
Let me use money as my capital.
We can't let me use money as my capital.
I don't know. I am struggling to impose this 3 minutes. How do we do it? Please come up with a strategy. 3 minutes. Thank you, doctor.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, Johannesburg. And we thank all of you for coming here to celebrate with us. And I believe each and every one of you seated in this room today would have contributed to this huge success today in one way or the other. Coming to my daughter that I'm very proud to talk about her, she was born before my very eyes. She pooed and peed on me, and I'm today celebrating her as a doctor, which is something that most parents don't often see. And the greatest honor that she's given us as a family, she's the first female doctor in our family. The man of God says something in his opening. I'm not very inclined in religion, but when you were saying something, you said it's difficult to see women venture in the field of science. But to you guys, I will say that unapologetically, that this is a scientific family.
Wow.
The father is a chemical engineer from Britain. The uncle comes immediately after the father is an IT technician with MTN Cameroon. The one that comes, follows that one, is a PhD holder in mathematics from UCT. Followed by me, I'm a PhD holder in chemistry. So it is a family of doctors in science. So it's not a coincidence. So coming to what Dr. Taka has gone through, she wake me up 2 a.m. Doc, I'm stuck. What can I do here? Say, do this, do that. One day she told me that she's applying for a bursary to go to China. I said to her, is your husband in accordance with this? He said, yes. That is why I admire my honorable in-law. You know, when my daughter wanted to, he was a suitor to my daughter told me, Uncle, there's somebody there in South Africa. He wants to get married to me, but I want you to investigate him. And I said to her, my daughter, I will tell you the answer, but you have to be patient. I did not know him. Mr. Meeting, we've been friends, childhood friends. I used to visit them, but I've never seen him. So I went to Botswana for a conference. On my way back, I missed my flight. One thing guy took me to, is it hip?
Connection bar,
yeah. So that was when I got to meet him. I did not know him, but somebody hinted him that that is the uncle of the lady you want to get. So he drew himself very close to me. And that friend got drunk and left me there. So he was the only person to rescue me, because I knew no way in Johannesburg. And he took me to my hotel safely at about 2 a.m. in the morning. And I flew back to Johannesburg, to Cape Town, safely. And I told my daughter, hey, something there for that man. So we carried on and on and on and on. And I've been in South Africa for 16 years, but I've never been to Johannesburg. Yes. The only time that I saw him again was on my way from Canada. I also missed a flight. So, I happened to meet him again that night at about 10 p.m. 5 a.m. again, I have to leave. That time I was lecturing in KwaZulu-Natal. I had to go to Durban. But what I want to say here is, from the few interactions that I've had with him, you don't need to take too much time to know somebody, whether he's a good person or a bad person. I would like to thank him sincerely for the great care that he has taken, the great care that and love that she has shown my daughter, and I think no father would be more proud than me standing here today, introducing my granddaughter as a top. In fact, when he told me that he has invited me to Johannesburg on several occasions, this time around he said, "Bah, I know, say you know, come now." I said to him, "Give me an hour." Within an hour, I sent him my air ticket. He said, "Wow, this is terrible." He said, "If I don't come, and today, I took my bath before then. There was a people in the window, bah, you know what I did?" I said, "Yes, this is what I came here for." Unfortunately, due to COVID, I could not enter the campus. I had to follow I had to stream it online anyway. So it is such a joyous moment in the lives of both families, because these two families, if they haven't worked together, we wouldn't have achieved something like this. And this should be an example to all of you seated here. If I can do it, why not you? Yeah, so sometimes when we came to South Africa, we wanted to go to school. People say that, oh, bad, and she goes to the very good. But it came to pass. Age is just a number. I think Prof. Tichawa is here. Prof, welcome. I don't come, I don't know, say data, I'm just saying that. I forget, say Corona, I don't die away. So, So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming here. And I believe the good God that has brought us here will take us to our various destinations safely and sound. And we will meet again some other time. Thank you so much.
We have heard the story about the long story about Bear's life, and we have also heard about Jay's life. Do we even need to say that they were destined to be together? It goes without saying that Ruth here found her Boaz, and Boaz here found his Ruth. If you are still trusting God, your own will come in Jesus' name. Amen. Offering time. Just say, well, offering lumber. Somebody is going to come to your aid. Somebody will come to listen to you. So we have our lady there who opened up the PSG road for us. And I'm going to call on Dr. Mrs. Ngi Adeline to come and say something to the rest of us who are still in this journey of becoming. Put your hands together for our first PhD Benin doctor. Please keep clapping now. You don't want PhD? Me, I want to. Me, I want. Please, keep clapping. 3 minutes, mommy. Tell us how you did it. We are coming behind.
All protocols duly respected. My seniors and my elders, my brothers and sisters. It is quite a moment for me, and this is because when I got the PhD, while many were celebrating that, or the first, I said, no, there are many to come. The reason I was proud to say there were many to come was because when I came to South Africa, we were celebrating the 10th anniversary of PDO. And that was the first time I met Jane. And when I met Jane, you know, they said people of the same manner, they always... Something brings them together. I don't want to say flock, because we really do not fly all the time, but she came close. And I struggled when I came to South Africa to get admissions into the university. She had the same problem. So when she came to me, we're sitting when we're doing the kids' party at Pat Marsan's place. I told her that I discovered the secret to get into the universities in South Africa. That with postgraduate admission, you take yourself there. You don't sit and send documents through the internet. And I'm giving that secret today to many. If you're here and you want to do your postgraduate, do not sit and be posting documents. Take yourself to that university, speak to somebody, and you will get in. So that is what we did with Jane. And I will tell you, it is not always a smooth ride, but for us women, it's even tougher. And I remember her days when we were in UJ, where she used to walk at times from Braamfontein there through to UJ. When we carried a backpack, people would laugh at us and say, what do they want to show us? Women are here, they are doing hairdressing, they are doing this, they are making money. You people want to go to school to show what? But I thank God today, we can be celebrated. And that's why she is being celebrated. But like they say, behind every successful man, there is a woman. I want to tell you that the reverse is quite true. The success has been because of the king behind this lady. Because so many will struggle. But if you will not have that person who will be able to give you the platform upon which you will study, then you will not move on. There are so many times that even in our discussions, she would tell me, you know what? She says, all I know is biochemistry. But I say, keep on with your biochemistry. Today we are celebrating biochemistry. And I want to thank God that it is not the last. We have many potential women. We have many potential daughters who we're celebrating at this platform with PhDs. And with that, we are saying that we will be moving to professorial level because it doesn't end there. And we know because our seniors have showed us that it is possible. They have showed us that it is possible. We are sitting here with two recently promoted professors of Cameroonian origin. And I want to be very proud to say that because it is not something that is very common. But again, I want to challenge them and challenge us to say that it is high time we encourage our own, we pull them up. Let us build a niche for ourselves. We have Nigerian professors who have Nigerian students, bringing them, grooming them up. By the time they get to professorial level, they have a PhD coming up. By the time they get to another, an administrative position, they are bringing those guys up. Let us also challenge ourselves to grow our community. I think I have also tried. There are so many of us here that they know that our paths have crossed because of education, but some of them fell back. I'm still encouraging you. We can do it and do it big. And so I pray that the God who has given us this opportunity to celebrate academics will help those that are falling back or those that are struggling to be able to get it. In Jesus' name.
Amen. My very own big brother, please put your hands together. Put your hands together. DJ Music, man. When you see young achievers, he's dancing off, he's not walking off. Professor Tichau, on the one that.
Hey! 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 Hey!
Hey! Hey! Hey! Hey! Hey! Hey!
You don't want me to start singing here. You see, you get 500 people the way you they represent, and 500 registered people there. You forget the other one never was. You see, only registered members. I was very worried if the Department of Home Affairs be there for here in first time. Thank you, and then you know the color today they say is red. I see madam is wearing red. You see the find that PhD too. You two just decide for where you are red and your own fever gown. Now a very good thing you know, they see. And I don't know where your co-MC is, you run. You mash money go she don't need for check your undershoe. Because start with the mashup and the studio. Let's check where some of that. And then they say the money don't come. And then now the Imam will ask for offerings. And again, that country talk, you are welcome. That country talk where they say where you talk and be very careful. No mind that talk where they talk. And if you come up on Jembe, you feel talk that kind of talk. All protocols observed. I'm very honored, Your Royal Highness and the Queen, for inviting me this evening to come and share what is a wonderful moment in the lives of your family, but most importantly, the community that you serve. Having listened to so many people, I mean, I don't know why you used to say the professor, because you just talk your work, but education is the most powerful tool that you can use to change the world, in the words of Nelson Mandela. And it is no fluke, it is true. And I repeat, education is the most powerful tool that we can use to change the world. Here we are today seated with a community leader and the wife, showing us the example of what it is that we need to do to move the world forward, but to start by also moving our community forward through education. And I was just sitting there praying that nobody should say it. But when I looked at what he is graduating in, Masters in Innovation. Masters in Innovation. The first thing I turned around and I told my wife was, wow, okay, Masters in Innovation. And then I just thought about what innovation means. I don't want to go into defining innovation, but we are in the era of the fourth industrial revolution, where we need leaders in society today that think out of the box. We need as community to innovate. And here is a king that has gone forward to study on innovation. I have no doubt that you will use this degree to innovate your community and the people that you serve. I was very touched, but I want to encourage you that that black rock must turn to red. Because if you can have a master's degree in innovation, you can have a PhD in innovation. And you can then join Madame, whom, you know, when I see women graduate with PhDs, I've graduated one lady with a PhD, and there's two more about to go. I can tell you about their journey. It is totally different from the men. Their journey is one that is characterized by so many little things in between. And if you are not a true man that supports your wife, and you want the best for your wife, she will leave that journey halfway. And here we have our Reverend Dr. Aki and the Reverend Dr. Patience Aki, who also recently graduated. When you listen to their story, and I'm sure, Queen, you have a story behind this PhD. Women that get PhDs, we need to celebrate them powerfully, in grand style. I can see it. My wife is about to do the same thing. And right now, the way she looks at me, every time, if she smiles, I know that I'm lucky today. Because she says, look at this thing, if I criticize it, then she says, but, you know, I'll be busy, I'll be giving a cookie, you see, one chon a okra, you want to do this one or that. The truth is that we need women that have PhD degrees, we need to really celebrate them. Why I am repeating this is because there are so many women seated in our Cameroonian community who are at the verge. They are touching this PhD, they can do it. All they need from us is the little push, and they can be able to do it. And when they have it, honestly speaking, I would say that Prof. Njobi, women professors are even better than us. I was mentored by women. My master's degree supervisor was a woman. The PhD supervisor was a woman. And they are the two most respected people that I can think of. When I was promoted to full professor, the first people I called was them to say thank you for the mentorship.
And so I'm picking up this button today. I know I've already done it. To ensure that we promote our women and make sure that they go to school. You've heard me in several places where I say, let us promote the women so that they should go to school, and they are the ones that are going to change the society. Thank you very much, and I want to congratulate you for this wonderful achievement. And I want to also thank you people for coming and witnessing this wonderful occasion with us. Thank you very much, Doctor from Cape Town. Take my greetings too today.
Woman, hey! Woman, hey! Woman, hey!
So I greet you. All protocols duly observed. Let me first of all start by thanking everybody also who has taken the time out to come here tonight to celebrate with us. Yes, so although I'm graduating my PhD, I actually don't really celebrate myself, honestly. Because when we spoke about making this party, I was like, nah, I don't really want a party. But to me, I felt like this party, to me, is all about Metaka. And I say that because the fact that I'm having this PhD today, yes, it is also because of him, his support. Each time when I would be down and I'd be like, no, my experiments are not working, or I'm having problems in the lab, or, you know, or yeah, lots of difficulties. And he'll keep on, although he criticizes me and my but he does that out of love. So that is his way of pushing me. So he pushes me in a forceful manner, yeah, to challenge myself. Yes, so that's his own way of pushing me. And when I would tell him that, no, this master's is hard, he would be like, oh no, what do you think a master's is? He would tell me that, no, that's nothing. And I'd be like, no, go and get your own. Then I would do it. Then you understand how hard it is.
Challenge.
Then I'm like, then he said, okay. Then he went and did his bachelor's degree. After his bachelor's degree, and I was like, I asked him, okay, so how was it? Now you, he's, as now that's why you no longer saw him in connection, because now he was still in the picture. During all of it, even became worse. He was no longer taking his name in connection because of the amount of time that he had now to study. Then now we was through. So now when he was through with his honors, we're now discussing about masters. He was like, okay, should he do an MBA at Mancosa? Should he go to VIT? And I'm like, no, change, it's good to change. Why go to a different university? And that's how he ended up finding himself at VET. And I say I celebrate him because what most people don't know is that he was actually doing two masters at the same time. So he used to tell me that he is an intellectual wizard. That I can say I agree with you now. Masters at the same time. That's why people are confused. MBA, Masters in Innovation Studies, he was doing both.
Concurrently.
Simultaneously. That's what people don't know. So he actually has two masters. A Masters in Innovation Studies from MET and a Masters in Business Administration from Mancosa.
I know the MBA. So I can say
I'm very, very proud of him, of my dear husband. Also because of the fact that whenever I was traveling, he was there with the kids. It's not easy for a man to take care of the kids. Most often I'll be troubled. He'll be like, no, they're fine. I'm taking care of them. And he will send me pictures, videos, for me to feel at peace that the children are okay. Yes.
So, and I would see how they were really enjoying themselves. And I felt jealous. I felt jealous, like, how, why is he the one enjoying with the kids? And I'm here out of the country, busy doing my own stuff. Yeah, but it's not an easy journey. Yeah, so once again, I thank you so much, Bear, for also being there to support me. Yeah! And for pushing me. Because when I started my PhD, he'll be like, when are you going to finish? He always decided, like, when are you finishing that PhD? When are you finishing that PhD? And I was like, well, no, but it's difficult. Like, no, finish that thing quickly. Like, so he also pushed me to try and make sure that I finish my PhD on time. Wow. Because of that constant push of telling me that I should finish it quickly. Yes. So I thank you for helping me complete my PhD in record, because it was not easy. So coming to where, when people used to see me traveling up and down, it's because of the fact that my field is the kind of field that's a little bit tricky, chemical pathology. Because when I started my PhD, when I wrote my proposal, doing research, medical research, is difficult because it requires a lot of money. A lot of money. I wrote on my budget I needed 1 million rand to do my project. My colleague asked, where are you going to get that money from? I said, I don't know, but I'll apply for funding from so many different organizations. So the reason why I was traveling up and down was because the fact that I had to forge these alliances to get the financial support I needed, to get the money I needed to carry out the project. So I was actually working with other countries who were supporting me with the project. So that's why I was always up and down. Yes. So yeah, so I thank him for always being there and allowing me also to go. Because it's not easy also for a man to leave his wife, go out. But yeah, I thank you for always being there to support me and to take care of the kids in my absence. And I thank you all for coming. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Openly acknowledging the key and for letting us know.
Good evening to all our friends who are in the house. I want to thank the former digger who came all the way from the Benin clan to be with us here today. The PDO president, Sufo, Dr. Ayok Peter, and all the rest. So let me not continue to call this name, because I would like to call each name until we come to the last person. Before I actually proceed, I want to call this my princesses that came with a phone so that I can release something very small for us to know. All of you girls who just graduated from the University of Malawi with their masters, stand up.
Bazani.
So even amidst the war in southern Cameroons, these gorgeous ladies just completed a master's in the University of Bamenda. Isn't it great?
It is. Wonderful. Amazing.
So I would like to encourage them to continue, because as most of our academic icons here have advised, that we need more women in education. The reason why I study is to inspire children and women, that's all. Because I think that if I'm telling a child to study more and more, they may ask me, but daddy, what about you? Or what do you do? And things like that. So I said, let me do this so that it could be a source of inspiration to them. But today is actually supposed to be a day that we're celebrating Queen Dr. Genenvive Taka. I'm just hiding behind her to also celebrate, to participate or to enjoy or to take part in this celebration, because it is these red robes that bring stars, that bring change, but not just them. I'm not saying that those who do not go to these schools do not bring change. So, today is your day. I do not want to participate in this graduation personally because I was afraid that when they come here, they will begin to say, but let me put it this way, I will be stealing her.
Doris.
Thank God that the house understood it, and the MCs, they knew exactly how to deal with this situation. Congratulations, my queen.
Wow.
I was looking for Professor Chawa and Professor Njobe. I would like to study again. So I don't know how you guys are going to admit me into a good project so that I can study some more. Let me especially thank Madame Victorine. Madame Victorine Bonsu, who gave us this hall during this COVID-19 period for us to come here and celebrate the Queen and also see faces again. I'm very proud of all of you. Today is Monday. She did not rent this hall to us.
Huh?
Yeah. So thank you. For all the gifts that I've seen, so many gifts here today, we want to thank you all. And we want to say, because of the time constraint that we're having in this hall today, when we leave here, we can go to the palace if we are not tired. So we can continue to celebrate. Celebrations don't end on the day that it starts. Even tomorrow, if you are tired today, the palace is there. Of course, the palace is the place for the people. Tanto, let me thank my elder brother here. Very fine gentleman. Very supportive. I don't want to challenge him. Because the only challenge I can give to him is to continue to support him. And he has been doing it so well. So what other challenge can I do? So thank you very much for all the support. One more second to say I'm very proud of this madam who is here. And like they say, we are always ready to support at any time. So if you want to proceed, we will still support. Therefore, we are even encouraging you to proceed. Because the support is there. And I want to add something very small to all the men in particular. But I see men have actually changed over the years. Men should do everything to support their wives, to be independent, whether they are doing business or they are studying. It is very critical, because when a family depends on the man only, if something wrong happens to the man, that family is finished. And the world today is not the world of yesterday. So it is actually the women who should be supported to the highest extent. Because as they have said, if you support a woman, then that is a whole village that you are supporting.
And they live long.
And the women should have the courage, the very strong courage, amidst their various motherly responsibilities, to keep doing something, because it will empower them, empower our communities. As I round up, I just want to say thank you again and say may God bless all of you. Let's celebrate.
Amen.
There's one more thing, please. Show this crown. Mayu, I don't want to tell the story of this crown because this crown was come and continue about this. What is it for? Where is it coming from?
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great privilege for me to stand here today to talk about this crown. In fact, we already know that this crown is coming from the Moa Palace in Pinyin. If some of us are here doubting where Pinyin is, it's in Cameroon in the Northwest region, precisely in Santa Subdivision. This crown has been brought here by the delegation from Cameroon, led by His Royal Highness Ifor Mandegun, and we as the princesses, we have come here to officially crown the Queen of Moa Palace, who doubles today as Dr. Mrs. Genevieve Taka. I want to use this opportunity to challenge the rest of our wives, to follow suit. Please, Queen, I hope you will hand the mantle to them.
Yes.
On that note, ladies and gentlemen, we do respect, we want to call on His Royal Highness Ifor Mandegun to come and officially crown the Queen of Moa Palace in SA. Thank you.
So now let doctor to move another doctor each up.
The larva. The crown. The damn chap woman you told. Pignina, the sugar. Ndapur, the samba, the ambushu. Ndapur, the poor, the pushu. Before Bruno, atta. Amu, atta mushu. Jotte la mochila, pignina, the pop, jilla, calipe, pitting la band, the king of the moon, jumla. Nkwama, the two motte la rura. Apparate la rinji. Kale ben burute laza ante larwe from sin emi pinyin e pomen zena ante larwe rtuwele na pofu nina na ponda pan samba amu pinyin objet la.
Oh,
hate. Me there, I just.
Let me bring the microphone to the one and only Professor Jove. 3 minutes, thank you.
First thing, I want to introduce myself. I'm the Minkari officer of the Muha Palace. I think one thing that I will say, okay, I have three, I'm going to speak in three folds, but I will start from the third one. The first thing is, the third one is about congratulating Mafo. You are hot. And first of all, your graduation, your achievement, I think it's really something on clinical pathology, your PhD in clinical pathology, or what we would say clinical biochemistry. I think it's about discovering the diseases using fluids. I tried to look, we've talked about it, but I'm not going to do talks on into that. But that is an achievement. And then the second one is about on innovation studies with my Mbe. One thing I will say about Mbe is that we have been friends. I remember crying sometimes before he was crying because we were friends, and then they made him, gave him all the huge responsibilities like this. I said, okay, we are not going to be going, we are no longer going to be going to this our funny places. But one thing stands out there. I think the challenges he engaged himself, in, I looked at it, even despite the fact that I'm a teacher, I didn't see it coming. But he made himself so much. He availed himself and those challenges. I see him pulling through that, and the wife has been there, Mafo. But before I proceed, I want to call on Madam Jo. Please stand up.
Hey!
We are still on. They gave us 3 minutes. I think Madam Jo got encouragement from, and she decided to also go back to school. You are going to finish my 3 minutes. She took that challenge and started doing her postgraduate diploma. She keeps saying that we should keep it low. But the second fold. But one of the things, please keep standing. She says, I should keep it on low key, but I want to really say how encouraging these two, they are supposed to, you know, to each and every one of us. I've removed people from our brothers and sisters on the street. I've supported them. Some of them have gone and graduated. But I think this should be an example. No. But one of the things that I also want to challenge them is the fact that... Did I But what I want to say is the challenge is not about them. succeeding, but I think there should be an exemplary characters here, so that we should all engage ourselves. And I also want to challenge them. I want to borrow. Okay, now that brings us to. I said three folds. Okay, fold number two. I want to borrow. Number three. Our famous leader of Tibet, Dalai Lama of China. I think he mentioned something. There are 2 days, only 2 days in the world that we don't have control over. Yesterday and tomorrow. I think, but we have control over today. Today is about us joining these two beautiful newlyweds to celebrate with them and to learn from or to just celebrate with them, because tomorrow we don't know what can be that holds for us. And then let me go to one. Give me 3 minutes. I don't know whether I'm exhausted. But what I want to say, Madame Jo is doing her postgraduate diploma in educational and leadership management. And I can see the smile in her every time. And then you need to see her shouting at me that she says I should photocopy this and but I want to tell you guys and girls, I want to tell you guys something. I am a teacher in the university, and I've never seen a smile in my wife as much as I've seen during this period when she is studying. And I want to challenge each and every one. If you want something that has to do with education, furthering your education, please call me. Even if I am not going to assist, I will call on each and every one to assist in my education. I just want to ask God Almighty that as He has brought us here to celebrate these poor people, let Him also be in charge of the God Father safely in Jesus' name.
Let my co-MC introduce the person. Thank you.
I've hardly come to an occasion where speeches are so sweet, so nice, and so entertaining like the ones we've had this evening. Professor Njome, Apolopo. You had the best speech of the evening. Oh, Prom says he needs an award for the speech. I'm a loser. And now we're rounding up the speeches before we get to that other part, that very important, interesting part, which we saw the other time. And the person who is going to come forth is, I did tell you the other time, he was the spokesperson, the mouthpiece of the Fund of Benin now. He is no other person. He traveled from Cameroon yesterday. He arrived the day before he arrived yesterday. He's still tired, but he's braved the odds to be with us today. He is one of the chiefs of Benin. He is a four Monday. Can we put a very, 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 very big hand as we invite the fun of Monday to give us a word?
Allah. Nami yaka. Ambo pun. Chinchi fumo pa ne. Chinchi fumo no gawo. Bete chong. Chinchi fumo pa ne zoku. Tene. Le gawo. A pong de
Should I be translating as the form is speaking that I won't until he's done? But I think, okay, the 13th language. Let him carry on and we would translate to those who could not understand.
Thank you, program director.
You know, I always felt that I have something to say when I have an opportunity. But now I realize how difficult it can be when you are caught after so much wisdom has been laid out. And therefore I choose to speak on something that is a theme that developed quite naturally as we listen to speaker after speaker. I greet everyone. And, you know, we're still getting used to associating with one of our traditional leaders here in Johannesburg. And while we're still getting used to that, suddenly we find ourselves in the room with two of them. I respect your royal highnesses. Now, the theme that developed that I was referring to was whether or not men whose women have completed a PhD before them should be intimidated and so on and so forth. I would just like to allude that that is possible. And where is the evidence? Look at me. So the first PhD we had in my own family was PhD by Lobola. It means we acquired the PhD through paying bride price. Wow. And therefore I want to honor my beautiful wife who is here, Dr. Anastasia Buma Ayo. Please just rise for recognition. So she was actually the first PhD in my family. And was I intimidated? Not at all. I don't think I look like someone who was intimidated. I was not intimidated because I have something that I see in my good friend. And that thing is called grace. It takes grace to be and to do what he does to be able to produce such beautiful fruits. And what is grace? For me, grace is what comes out of when you combine tenacity. You know, tenacity, resilience. Another word for that in pidgin is chop fire. Okay? It's when you combine tenacity on the one hand and humility on the other. And so it's exciting when I hear stories about before Taka, you know, about connection and so on and so forth. I just thought, well, maybe it's a wonderful thing that I did not really know him at that time of his life. Because I think I got to know him, I barely knew him, until he emerged as Mfomua. And therefore my memories of him are of nothing but royalty. And then I'm very thankful, very proud to be a friend of this family, a friend of the Mua Kingdom, a friend of, by extension, the entire Pinyin clan. So thank you for the honor. We're celebrating today something that is special, and I think there is a lot that could be said, but I'm very mindful of time, and I just want to say congratulations. Well done.
Thank you so much. Thank you. We are going to have one or two last speakers, and then there's a very mighty cake here in front of us. And you know what the song says, together we shall move the mountain. So it looks like it's a big mountain. I'm not the one to unveil it. But for now, I'm going to call on my brother, Mark Kevin. He has 3 minutes to talk to us before we go to, we are saving the best for last. So before we hear from our mighty man in the house.
Hello everyone. I'm really privileged, but at the same time, I'm not surprised that I'm speaking here tonight. I've come a long way with a very good friend, Mbe, someone who, I mean, everyone has said a lot of things. Mr. Taka, he said a lot of things, and for that, I am really inspired. He's inspired me for a very long time. I remember the first time that I heard, most of you call him sir, you don't even know how he came about. But the first time that I became this man, I would call him this man because we were very angry. He drove us, you know, he was sitting in front of the, as we entered the class, the hall, down school, JHS, Jibetas Mbengi now. he will ask you all sort of questions before you even enter there. So everybody was even, a lot of students thought he was the teacher, so they call him sir. So everything that you said, maybe you cut it short and bring it to London. We saw it there. And I'm glad that my very good friend, Devin, is here, classmate with the junior sister in Bengi. But when I arrived in South Africa, I saw something different in him. And it was not that guy that we used to know. That guy that we heard, or the guy who asked us all sort of questions before we could enter and read it out school hall. It was someone who completely decided and chose a purpose and said, I want to be better and I want to be something better. And I remember we became, again, it continued from that person. But I remember he was one of those people that when I was writing my Microsoft MCS, the Microsoft Service Systems Engineer, I remember he was already done. And he had already an opportunity with APSA. And I told him that this is the direction I was going. And then I met him in Braamfontein. And he was telling me how these things work. That's the direction I want to go. And he really, really, really taught me, showed me the path. And when he joined APSA, at other point, a few months later, I was at FMB. But this would not have been possible, like I said, behind every successful man. Some say they are women, but I would say that some is family. It's a male insanity, really. I would not have followed that path. The people that you meet shape your life in one way or the other. I would not have followed that path if not my father, Mr. Fernando Harrison. When I arrived in this country, he said to me, my business, I said, shoes, I travel, bring shoes, and I said, I know you are not the type of person that I want you to do that. I've been this, I've been that. I don't think that because I've been on this journey, you should be that way. I know you like school, and you should follow that path. And I followed his word, he supported me, and the little that I am today is because of that man. So please give a hand of applause to Mr. Fernando. But today, it's not about me, it's not about him, but we talk about innovation. And for Prof, who is married to my sister, I'm proud. So, at least let me fix my my sister will be a doctor, will come someday, no problem, no day. But right now, we can inspire in different ways. Remember, like they said, you may not be a doctor, you may not be a professor, you may not be a master degree holder. You have a purpose. Follow your purpose. Make a difference in your purpose. Look at it as what happened to my children, my grandchildren. What happened when I die? What do people talk about me? The Taka said it, that Mbeh bought his car 6 months better than his. He had a purpose, he had a vision, he decided, he followed it. He wanted to be somebody, he wanted to be respected. We've seen it in every way, so him being there is not something that is new for anyone. Most of us, if not all, knew that him being there is something we needed as a community, as a Cameroonian, as a people. He's shown it in everything that he's done. I've done so many things with him. I mean, Cameroonians are enjoying our Cameroon, African festival, we under the Cameroon festival when we used to do it. We've done that, community building has been our thing. Making an impact in our community has been our thing. But today, I know, speaking today, I'm going to speak about what he just graduated from. Innovation, Masters in Innovation. What is that? I think a lot of people confuse two things. When somebody hear innovation, somebody hear invention, there are two different things. But without commercialization, innovation equals invention. And then invention times commercialization, it comes back to innovation. It means that what? Where I am my name is Kevin Ayeba, I am the founder and CEO of Startup. We focus on commercializing invention so that my bear, the idea that the generation can then take it to the market, to follow the, make the processes work. That's what innovation is. So for him to acknowledge that, I know that I already have, again, a partner that we have been for a very long time in developing community in South Africa. We have it again in this space, technology and innovation, to build further our people. So my specialty is focused on entrepreneurship, but more importantly, technology entrepreneurship. I focus on people who take ideas, use technology to enable it. And that's where he comes from. So today, we have just read, I mean, it's taken us a long time, being an engineer, all of us, work in the bank, do whatever we wanted. But again, it comes to what we call a purpose. So we have, the last few 2 years, we have developed a platform called Set Up a Startup. It is a school of entrepreneurship. So anyone can join us. Anyone can check us out, setupastartup.org. It is a school of the entire journey of you being an entrepreneur, entire journey of developing something, and then we can commercialize it for you. Today, I'm very honored. Thank you so very much, Mbe. Congratulations to all the women. Congratulations to everyone who's been here. Thank you, MC.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Mark. And right now, I'm going to call on Professor Njobe to come and tell us something about you.
Come there.
On a one, I sang that on. On a look at us. On a look at us. Sorry, we are not raising funds yet. But I mean, if it was me, I would not come in like that. Okay. My beautiful, anointed, powerful women, I respect you all so much. Please just stretch your hand and hold the cake from one angle, the cloth. We are not unveiling yet. Okay. Don't make a mess. If your wife is here, Sangran, the husband of are they ready? Okay.
Some people are single. All of them.
When I look at them, they look different size. That is not me. Okay, give me a day. We are going to thank Jesus, the one who makes all things possible. It is by his grace that we are here today to celebrate these achievements. A J.
J.
An E.
E.
An S.
S.
A U.
U.
Another S.
S.
And who does it spell?
Jesus.
Together. Thank you all so much. Thank you, my mommy. You can take your seat. Thank you, honorable women of the Pinyin clan.
This is the cake.
Okay, so right now I'm going to invite a cameraman. Please position yourself so that the people are able to see. Thank you. Please, I'm going to. Okay, as we are getting ready to cut the cake, it's very important that we hear from the architect, the person who designed this cake. I'm sure she had something in mind when she was putting this cake together, the colors and the caps and everything. So can I call on my beautiful sister to come and say something about the cake before we cut the cake?
Lulu, come again.
The designer.
She is a queen in her own right.
Queen, so, Lulu,
come
again.
Thank you. Oh, according to the caps.
Hello. Hello. Good evening, everyone. All protocol observed. I know most of you know me, but some doesn't know me. I'm Lolo Kamankent, Mrs. Africa Global Universe.
Bam!
Bam! I'm also marriage and relationship coach.
Yeah.
So I'm happy to see everything is graduating. I graduated my own under lockdown. I'm shaking because it's a long time, and because of you and Bear. Bear, I don't know what you did to me. I'm still investigating. For you to make me to be here today, I don't know, but I'm here by the grace of God. I'm in this venue because this is the first time I don't attend event here. But because of you, I say I can't. I cannot both of you, because we are like family and also like a princess from a royal home. I understand what it means for a royal family to have a graduation. Can I call you Sir a bit? Because you know, you are my best friend, and you are always there to direct me. We have gone a long way. I remember when you sent me a photo of your honors. Then I was like, wow, when did this happen? You said, don't worry, another one is coming. I didn't know that it would be so soon. But I'm happy that I'm the one managing this event to make sure that everything goes well. When I was designing this cake, it was very difficult because it's the first time I'm doing a cake for graduates or what they call them, whatsoever. With one in two. I don't say two in one, I say one in two. So I thought about it, and they have been there a lot for my friend Jean. I know you have been telling me, but in the other hand, they have been saying women or PhD is higher than MBA. But for me, MBA is higher than PhD. Do you know why? Because it's a chief. It's a chief that is receiving this. She is here, yes. But today we are celebrating Mben for me. Because it's the first time in my history for a chief to graduate with an MBA. Yeah. Okay, that's what we should do. All right. Yeah, so congratulations. I'm so honored standing here to give the history of your cake. If you can see at the bottom, it's a blue.
And that blue represents you, Mbe, because it's royal blue from the palace. I didn't want to put those colors, because as a graduation staff, I said, no, it needs to be shining and sparkling. In the middle, that represents our queen. Queen Dr. Genevieve.
Oh, yes.
Because of the star and the flowers, and women who wear pearls, you know. So that one represents you. And inside the cake, we have vanilla. Vanilla go for pureness. Pure in heart. You are so humble. And chocolate is sweet love. Then I was thinking, what can I do for both of them? That is why I asked you about the picture. So I put this picture in between to say, this journey that both of you have started, and if I remember properly or well, you encourage him to do this. I congratulate you. Because no, not every woman will push their husband to say, I can't be going forward while you are behind. We need to move together. So thank you very much. Keep it on. And I know with your humanity, we'll go longer. Amen. So that is why I put your photo. If you see the picture is from there, on the invite. I took it, and a heart. So that heart, the heart represents, we know it's one heart, but for me, one heart goes for both. So if your heart beats, his own is beating. If his own beats, yours is going. It's the same. So on the certificate, it was supposed to be two, but I said no. Together forever. So that is why I put one certificate that both of you, we have it. And all of them, they are eatable, eh?
Yes.
No, it's eatable. It's eatable. So then for the hat, I was thinking to make one, then put two different colors. Then I said, no, for that one, I'll put separate. But Mbe is going to take your hat. And you will receive Mbe's hat. And remember, they are eatable, so you can keep it in your fridge. Then you are watching at it. So Mbe, the PhD hat is for you to say, thank you for encouraging her, for you to be there. I know sometimes you would call me, you say it's difficult. I said, no, you are doing well. When she's going all around, but you are there taking care of the children. Not every man will do that. I say, thank you. And never, never. You feel down. Know that she is there for you. When you feel down, you call her. So, and on the, you can see the logo. What is so interesting me that I was so happy, because both of them, they are having their degree in one university. The same university. So on this hand, I would say congratulations. I'm behind you. I told you that it's difficult with having children and going to school and what. But thank you very much for doing this. And I'm honored to stand here today to speak on behalf of the cake that represents both of you. I'm grateful. And may the Lord Almighty that have been keeping you guys together never fail in your means. Never despair from your home. You should always know that the Lord is there. Even when you are feeling bad, kneel down in front of your bed and cry to the Lord. He will answer you. The same to you, men. I know that the royal family will also know God. I'm happy.
Which means the graduation that is taking place today for the graduates is extremely overwhelmed. Yeah. We have to give a hand of applause today. And so I've been given the opportunity to toast this wine on behalf of the graduates who have to do systematically. But before we do it, I want to first of all thank my friend who introduced this very intelligent rascal to me. He's my friend. When he introduced this rascal to me, I thought he was a useless one. I realized that he's an intelligent one.
Next door.
Because he survives in almost all environment.
Yeah.
You know, the first thing that he surprised me was when he became a community leader. He was supposed to have a honorary qualification. He was supposed to have got it long ago.
Yes.
In
what we call the Cameroon Physical Tournament, as well as veteran Johannesburg. Yeah. This man is a backbone behind it. In the context, of Southern Cameroon, you have had a honorary qualification, honorary doctor.
It's on his way.
Yes.
What long ago?
Yeah, the wife would have been joining.
The wife would have been catching him from behind. not even the wife proceeding before he's coming behind. He got it long ago, honorary qualification.
Yes.
Yes.
And based on that, I want to call on the ambassador of Cameroonian community here to give this man, he has a big idea, a big hand of applause. So when he told me that he will be having a graduation ceremony at Victorine von Schuster, I thought he was joking. He and the wife, I thought they were joking to me. Victorine von Schuster and Dr. Nyema at the vicinity here, I never thought it was going to be a reality. Today, I look at the very glamorous environment. It shows that the graduation is met with a lot of achievement and a lot of happiness, which means you've done it through the right process. And I want to say, what you are doing here, particularly the Southern Cameroonians or Amazonians or Cameroonians, please, when you do the right thing, here in South Africa, you are rewarded based on your achievement. It is not in Cameroon where people call it that you go to the university and create. Otherwise, most of you have become professors or doctors here. You create in the university in Cameroon. But here is a different environment where
before you come, that is
Before you see it, the soul to be pom-pom. Before you see it, the soul to be pom-pom. Before you climb this ladder, to be pepe. Taka, happy new day to you. Queen Taka, happy new day to you. Queen Taka, happy new day to you.
We are not going to be able to do it.